First of all, I'm really grateful to ICML and LatinX to, you know, provide me the travel grant so that I could manage to come here and present my research work in front of you all. So the topic of this paper is an introduction to quantum natural language processing, a study case. So the author of this paper, Javier, and I, we met in a conference last year in December. And Javier were presenting papers on quantum mechanics, and I was presenting papers on NLP, natural language processing, and ML. So we thought that we can, you know, club these two concepts together and see how it works. So first of all, I'll discuss few quantum terminologies. Like in classical computer, we use Turing machine, we use transistors, so it can be like one state, either zero or one. While in the case of quantum mechanics, the state is called qubit, and it can be zero and one at the same time. So quantum computing takes concepts from quantum mechanics to enhance classical computing, entanglement, teleportation, superposition concepts, etc. So I'm going to briefly explain these concepts. Like superposition is like qubit can have both the values zero and one at the same time. Entanglement is like the systems are highly correlated to each other, that information gain from one system will give you the information of the other system as well. Teleportation uses the no cloning theory to say that we cannot simply make an exact copy of an unknown quantum state. So classical natural language processing, NLP, language is carrier of information. So whenever we want to convey something, convey any information, so language is the way, right? So sentences are not just bag of words. It is a process that makes meaning of words, produces the meaning of sentence, so that we can teach machine the meaning, the exact grammatical structure, maybe the context, linguistic part, etc. of the sentence. But this is the goal, like deep understanding, but the reality is the shallow matching. So in this case, natural language processing techniques are employed to, you know, handle such tasks. So Siri, like most of the features provided by Siri, like speech recognition, language analysis, text-to-speech, are part of NLP. So NLP concepts involve machine learning, word embeddings, language models. There are transformer models which support multilingualistic features. And it has diverse applications like intent mining, generation of response text, machine translation, etc. So in my PhD, I did fake news detection. So I used NLP techniques for pre-processing of the data. So in order to make it in a structured form, which can be easily understandable by the machines. So there are other applications of NLP, like question answering. This is the state of the art that whenever, sometimes it happens that when we write very long sentence, when we search a very long sentence on Google, it shows like it did not match any documents. So NLP techniques, you know, are working on it so that we can do the factoid instead of, even if we are not able to find the perfect match. Summarization is also a very wide example of using NLP techniques. So the idea is like we are clubbing together applied quantum computing and natural language processing NLP so that we can work on QNLP. So the workflow is any sentence, we develop the parse tree and the syntax tree from the sentence in order to express the grammatical structure of the sentence. And if we are dealing with classical computers, then we develop the tensor circuits. And if we are dealing with the quantum computers, we basically develop quantum circuits. So quantum language circuits, so there is a physical restriction in natural language, like whenever we speak, we write in a sequential manner. So syntax trees, which are, you know, expressing the dependency of information, or whenever we are developing the dependency graphs from the sentence, these are two-dimensional, right? So like whenever we are telling any story or we are expressing any information, so this is like a walk over this network, and this is known as the language circuit. So in this paper, we basically use DiscoCAT model. DiscoCAT is basically from the Lambeck quantum toolkit. So like in classical NLP models are distribution models. That is, the meaning of sentences are calculated by using counting, by counting the occurrence of words, by finding out the similarity between the words, semantics between the words, but the exact grammatical structure is lost somehow. So in the case of DiscoCAT models, which proves that the structure of entanglement in quantum mechanics is similar to that of the pre-group grammar through compact closed category theory. So with this split diagram, we are trying to show that the egg can be as an input and the output, we are getting by merging the white and yolk for the output in the final. So this is like showing how it works, like converting parse trees into quantum circuits. So here we can see there are different qubits and different gates available, and we are converting the parse tree into the quantum circuits here. So for the experimental part, we developed different quantum circuits using control U gates, control NOT gates, measurement gates, etc. And this is the parameterization. We used 5 qubits with random entanglements and different operators and like gates. So basically, this quantum mechanics part was done majorly by Javier. So he will be joining us during the poster session in the evening. So we can discuss these concepts in the poster session. So this is the experimental, this is the encoded circuit that we developed for the sentence like "I play tennis." So we passed this sentence and we used 5 qubits here. And these are the gates and the operators that we use to develop the circuit. We can develop other circuits as well, but in this experimental part, we encoded this in this quantum circuit. So QNLP has like wide applications in language translation, exploration of fake news, data pre-processing, speech recognition, question answering. So as this is a new research area in quantum AI, and the potential gains are still being explored. Researchers are working on this area to explore its applications in different domains. So these are the areas that we are also targeting to extend our work in future. And that's how we are planning to extend this work. So thank you.
Thank you, Shubhangi.